Okay, can we acknowledge ourselves for being here in spite of all the stuff that's going on today? Come on, give it up, give it up, give it up. Give it up, give it up, give it up to you. Take a breath, take a breath, take a breath, take a breath, take a breath.
It's been a long time that I had to say. When I wake up in the morning, all I do is pray. Wasn't God in no attention on the streets today. Had an answer to the questions I get every day. Used to fly.
Oh, yeah. Take a breath, take a breath now.
I remember in the days when we were one heart, no need to defend. I just went on.
So remember, you don't have to believe. Let's say, hey, hey, hey. The ideas, and you need not even welcome the ideas, and some of the ideas you may actively resist, some of the ideas you may actively resist, some of the ideas you may actively resist, so go, hey, 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 no matter how life is today, we got to live in this moment, and hey, don't let this moment slip away. Hey, hey, hey. Don't let this moment slip away. You may find it hard to believe. You may find it quite startling. You may find it hard to believe. You may find it quite startling. You may find A Course in Miracles very hard to believe. You may hear some things that seem quite startling. You might hear some things that seem quite startling. You are not
that
there.
Couldn't be done. Don't let nobody ever tell you that we couldn't be one. Don't let nobody ever tell you that it shouldn't be so. Don't let nobody ever tell you you're the only one.
Ha ha ha.
See you.
Hey, hey.
No matter how life is today.
Come on, y'all. Come on. Say, your way. I say, hey, 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 no matter how it seems today, there's some sunshine coming your way. Is that right? Give it up! Yeah. That's what I'm talking about. Happiness is a decision. It's not a set of circumstances. You have a good time when you have a good time when you decide to have a good time.
Mm-hmm.
It's not when somebody does something you think you like the way you want it done. Waiting for the world to change before you let yourself have a good time. You're going to be waiting a long time. I'm going to cover part of the Course in Miracles today that's going to be one of those sections that's pretty deep. I'm going to cover as much of it as I can. It's called I Need Do Nothing. Some of you all have been very successful at that, much to you. your disappointment. It's been something you've been very good at, doing nothing. Now, how can we use that to our advantage? It's in page 388 in the Foundation for Inner Peace version of A Course in Miracles, chapter 18. I'm going to read four paragraphs without stopping.
Whoa.
I'm scared.
Whoa.
Now, I want you to know it'd be perfectly okay when you fall out of the chair or sleep before I get through with the four paragraphs. This is going to release you from all pressure of staying conscious.
We want Raj back.
Okay. You still have too much faith in the body. Okay, bring it in, y'all. Bring it in. Hear a lot of conversation. Please bring it in. Please bring it in. You still have too much faith in the body as a source of your strength. What plans do you make that don't involve the body's comfort? What plans do you make that don't involve the body's protection or enjoyment in some way? You probably got some plans today that have something to do with your body's enjoyment and pleasure today. But this makes the body an end or a goal. This makes the body an end or a goal. So you're not using your body as a means to achieve a higher goal. You're using your body as a means to still keep fear attractive. That sounds like a pretty woman walking down the street.
That's an attractive sin right there.
That's an attractive woman fear right there. Okay. Nobody's going to accept the truth for themselves where they still have fear as their goal. So you haven't met your one responsibility. So your atonement, your correction, your healing is not welcome if you prefer pain and destruction. So a person that welcomes pain and who prefers to be in pain doesn't welcome love. Mm-hmm. A person that prefers pain does not welcome healing. So there's just one thing you've never done. There's 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 one thing you have 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 never done. Do you know there is one thing you have never done? There's one thing you have never done. You've never utterly forgotten the body.
Got that right.
There's not a second that you've forgotten the body. Utterly, totally forgotten the body.
Wow.
I know the body has perhaps faded at times from your awareness. In your sight, sometimes the body has faded away from your sight, but you haven't completely let the body disappear. So you're not asked to utterly forget your body for more than just an instant. If you could forget your body for just an instant, it would be in that instant that the miracle of your healing occurs. If you could just let go of your focus on the body for just an instant, you would have a total healing.
Wow.
Now afterwards, you would see the body again. Once your mind is healed, you would see the body again. You would still see the body again after your mind is healed because you utterly forgot it just for an instant, but never quite the same. You never see your body the same way if you just forgot it for one instant long enough for spirit to correct your mind. And every instant that you spend without awareness of the body, every instant that you spend without awareness of the body, every instant that you spend without awareness of the body, every instant that you spend without awareness of the body will give you a different view of the body when you return to your awareness of the body. Now, this is really deep. At no single instant does the body exist at all.
No.
There's no single instant that the body is existing at all.
Wow.
There's no single instant that the body is existing at all. What the heck does that mean? Well, it means that you are either remembering the body or you are anticipating the body, but you're never really experiencing your body right now.
Wow.
You're thinking about something relative to your body from what you learned in the past about the body, or you're projecting something that you hope is going to happen in the body with the body in the future, but you're never just actually experiencing your body right now. So only the past of your body and the future of your body actually makes your body seem real. Your body's past makes your body seem real, and what you think you're gonna do with your body in the future is what makes your body real to you. So that means time controls the body. Time controls the body entirely. Time controls the body. The body is controlled by time. This body doesn't look like the body that was running around 30 years ago.
Nope. And
the body I saw Doug just on his Facebook.
Oh, man.
I went, my God.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, somebody posted a picture of Doug. I guess you were on with you, Doug.
In that picture?
Yeah.
Oh, God. I think I was 17, 18.
What? Wow. Doug looked like Mr. Universe.
Yeah. I know.
Man, pets, it looked just like me. I mean, I look just like in your hair.
Yeah.
Yeah, I used to have hair too, Doug.
Fast.
I did. I'm on a hair fast.
It's working.
It's working. It's working. So time controls the body entirely. So sin or fear is never completely in the present. You're never really completely afraid right now. You're not really, really completely afraid right now. Now you're actually safe. So any fear that you're experiencing right now is fear about what's going to happen in the future or something that happened in the past. You're not ever experiencing fear right now because you're safe right now. So there's no need to be afraid of anything right now. We're safe right now. You're not threatened right now. Everything is okay right now. So if you're afraid right now, you're not being present right now. If you're afraid right now, you're not being present right now. If you're afraid right now, you're not being present right now. You're thinking about something from your past and you're projecting something that might happen in the future, but you're not being present with us right now. If you're afraid right now, if you're upset right now. Mm. So show up. Mm. Arrive in the class. Mm-hmm. Okay, because you got some cool, juicy people all around you right now. The coolest people you could ever imagine. So if you're sitting up here being a sourpuss, you need to arrive. Especially as much as gas costs.
What'd you say?
Especially as much as gasoline costs. You know, you drove, you got in your car, you put on clothes to not let everybody just see how much you're unhappy. So then the Course in Miracles says, and this is really deep. So it says, time controls the body correctly. Your sin or fear is never totally in the present. So that means in any single instant, the attraction of guilt would be experienced as pain and nothing else. So when a person feels pain, they're just feeling their attraction to guilt. Mm-hmm. When you're hurting, you're just feeling your attraction to guilt and nothing else. And if a person really knew that in any single instant the attraction of guilt would be experienced as pain and nothing else, then you would start to avoid the attraction to guilt. When you start to love yourself, you will automatically stop doing things that make you feel guilty.
Yeah.
When you love yourself, you'll stop doing things that make you feel guilty. When you love yourself, you'll stop doing things that make you feel guilty. It doesn't mean that the thing that you're doing is something you should feel guilty about, but if you're feeling guilty about it, you're gonna give yourself some pain through whatever you feel guilty about. You're gonna give yourself some pain through whatever you're feeling guilty about. Mm-hmm. Stop it.
Oh. Yeah.
Just stop it.
Just stop it.
Alrighty.
Just stop it. Addictions are not about the thing the person is addicted to. Mm-hmm. It's not sex that's the addiction. It's the guilt that you get from it that's the problem. And that's what you want, is the guilt. It's the guilt from smoking. It's the guilt from the drug. It's the guilt from the eating. It's not the thing that you, because plenty of people are doing those things and feeling innocent.
Yeah.
Everybody that get high don't feel guilt about it.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Colorado.
Thank you, Colorado.
All right. But those of you who feel guilty, don't do it.
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 Just say no.
Just say no.
Go to Kansas.
That's right. Go somewhere else. Y'all driving up the rents. All these people just coming from out of the city. Y'all need to go. Y'all driving up the rents.
That's right. Okay. There's too many people not feeling guilty about that.
You know, I know a person that there were people, they were doing a bed and breakfast, and people came in from out of town just to get high. Mm-hmm. and it wouldn't go nowhere. Go on, come on, man. It's you need to be here all day.
You can see the mountains.
You know, go see the mountains. Just don't fall off a cliff. That's right. So if you knew that by doing what you feel guilty about, you know you're just asking for pain, then you would avoid doing that. You would change your mind about it. Because everything in the world is neutral. You determine the effect it's going to have on you. Everything in the world is neutral. Everything in the world is neutral. Everything in the world is neutral. But you have no neutral thoughts about anything. This is a neutral class. I'm a neutral guy saying neutral things, but you don't have a neutral reaction to what you're hearing.
No.
Some people hear what I'm saying and it brings them joy. Some people hear what I'm saying and it brings them fear. But I'm not going to change what I'm saying, because it really doesn't matter what I say, because you're going to see it the way you want to see it. Mm-hmm. So the only thing that matters is that I'm saying what I want to hear the way I need to hear it. Mm-hmm. And that's true with everybody you talk to. Yes. Nobody's ever hearing what you're saying. Haven't you noticed?
Yes. Yes, I have.
Okay.
Yes. Right.
You can try to be as clear as you can be and they'll still miss it.
Yep.
If that's the interpretation of what you see that they want. And they're only listening in terms of what they want to join with or what they want to separate from. Mm-hmm. If somebody wants to separate from you, there's nothing you can say that's going to change their mind. They're going to still come up with a reason to be separate from you. Mm-hmm. If they want to forgive you, if they want to join you, you can say almost anything and they'll be glad to overlook the past so they can join with you right now. So if you're trying to clear up something with somebody, save yourself a lot of time. Just at the very beginning, before you get into any discussion or processing, say to that person, do you want to join or do you want to separate?
Mama may have, Papa may have, but God bless the child that's got his own.
Yeah.
That's got his own.
This is the way black folks say it. In a single instant, the attraction of guilt would be experienced as pain and nothing else, and would be avoided, 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 avoided. Pain and guilt has no attraction right now. The whole attraction to pain and guilt is imaginary. Your whole attraction to pain and guilt is imaginary. It's coming from something that you are imagining. So all your pain and guilt, just think of it as something coming from the past. And all your pain and guilt, think of it as something coming from the future. And past means gone. I'm thinking of the gone. I'm thinking of the not yet. I'm thinking of the gone. I'm thinking of the not yet. I'm thinking of the gone. I'm thinking of the not yet. I'm thinking of the gone. Thinking of the love of the past. I'm thinking of the love that's gone. I'm thinking of what's gonna happen in the not yet. It's keeping me from being in the present. Stop, stop keeping yourself in the gone of the not yet. Don't worry about being successful in your ability to let go of the past. Don't worry about being successful in your ability to let go of the past. You know why? Because you cannot not let go of what's already gone. It's already gone. So don't worry about it. So, it's impossible to accept one instant of happiness. It's impossible to accept one instant of happiness without reservation. It's impossible to accept a happy instant without reservation, unless just for an instant, just for an instant, just for an instant, just for an instant, you must be willing to see no past or future. It's impossible to be happy in this moment right here unless you're willing to see no gone or no not yet. Let go of the gone, let go of the not yet. You cannot prepare for happiness. You cannot prepare for happiness. You cannot prepare for happiness without placing your happiness in the future. When you prepare for your happiness, you're placing your happiness in the future. When you prepare for your happiness, you're placing it in the future. When you prepare for your happiness, you're placing it in the future. When you prepare for something, you're placing it in the future. Say what? Yes, but. So release is given you the instant you desire release. So your release is given to you the instant that you desire it. Your happiness will be given to you the instant that you truly desire it. Did you hear me? Your happiness will be given you. It didn't say earned by you. It didn't say paid for by you. It didn't say bargained for by you. It said release is given you the instant you desire it. Release is given you. The instant you desire it, release is given to you.
Want it now.
Many have spent a lifetime in preparation. This is really deep right here. Let's discuss it in a minute. Number four paragraph. Many have spent a lifetime in preparation. Many have spent a lifetime trying to prepare themselves for happiness. Many have spent a lifetime trying to prepare themselves for happiness. Many have spent a lifetime trying to prepare themselves for what they want. Many have spent a lifetime trying to prepare themselves for love. Many have spent a lifetime trying to prepare themselves for love. And the Course in Miracles says they have indeed achieved their instance of success. They have indeed achieved their instance of success. And this course doesn't attempt to teach more than people who did achieve their instance of success learned in time. But the purpose of the course is saving time. The purpose of this class is to save you time. The purpose of a relationship should be to save you time. The purpose of a relationship should be to save you time. Help you get to happiness, joy, and peace quicker, faster. The purpose of a relationship is to help you come to the realization of the incredible being you are faster.
Yeah.
It's not there to slow you down.
Yeah.
So what does the Course in Miracles says? It says it does aim at saving time. You may be attempting to follow a very long road. You may be attempting to follow a very long road. To what? The goal you've accepted. I said I want to be happy, I want love. And he says, but you may be tempted to follow, check this out, follow a very long road. Yeah. Follow
right.
A very long road. It's extremely difficult to reach love, which is atonement. It's extremely difficult to reach happiness and correction and healing by fighting against sin.
Yeah.
By fighting against guilt, by fighting against something.
Yeah.
It's extremely difficult to reach your peace by fighting against this and fighting against that.
Yep.
I'm fighting this. I'm fighting a cold.
Right. I'm fighting sin.
I'm fighting sin. Enormous effort is expended in the attempt to make holy what's hated and despised. Do you know that most people are trying to make themselves love what they don't love, like what they don't like?
Yes.
They're trying to make themselves love a job they don't love, love a person they don't love, love a financial situation they don't love, love a city they don't love, love a state of mind that they don't love. Most people think being spiritual is making yourself like something you don't. So if I can get to the point I like the person that I hate, I'm being spiritual. The Course in Miracles is saying to us that enormous effort is expended in the attempt to make holy, innocent, and happy what is hated and what is despised, nor is a lifetime of contemplation and long periods of meditation, nor is a lifetime of contemplation and long periods of meditation, nor is a lifetime of contemplation and long periods of meditation aimed at what? Detachment from the body necessary. You don't have to keep meditating and contemplating to try to get detachment from the well and detachment from your body. Long periods.
Long periods.
Long periods. You, if you meditate 24 hours a day, the Course in Miracles says all such attempts will ultimately succeed.
That's good.
So if you are meditating, if you are contemplating, if you are trying to detach yourself from the body, it will ultimately succeed. If you are meditating and contemplating, I'm not saying don't meditate and contemplate. I am saying you can achieve your goal if you meditate and contemplate, but the means are tedious and very time consuming. Sometimes when I try to do a lot of stuff, when I try to do a lot of little meditations and I try to do a lot of yoga and stuff, it's almost killing me. I thought I was going to be a downward dog. I thought I was going to be a dead dog. I was so busy concentrating on the pain that was going through from the position that I didn't even remember nothing about who I was. I was just pain. That's who I was. Some people not know they yoga-fied. You know what I'm saying? They can handle some yoga. They can do their bodies be like little rubber bands and twisting all around. You know what I'm saying? But for me,
it was tedious and time consuming.
But that doesn't mean it's tedious and time consuming for the person that wants to do it. It doesn't mean that it's in any way but a beautiful thing for the person that loves to do it. But the Course in Miracles says, what's happening is, in all these things that you're doing, you're just looking to the future for a release from a state of present unworthiness and inadequacy. Wow. We believe that if we study enough, yoga enough, read enough, run enough, whatever we do, that it's gonna free us from a present sense of inadequacy. Right. There's something wrong with me now, yes. And if I do all these different things, I'm going to be a lot better in the future.
Yeah.
And the Course in Miracles says, your way will be different.
Yay!
Your way will not be tedious, your way will not be time consuming, your way will not be tedious, your way will not be time consuming, your way will not be tedious, your way will not be time consuming. This is your way. You got another way. Yoga fine, contemplation fine, meditation fine, all the things that people are doing that their heart is telling them to do for the purpose of knowing how to love themselves more. It's beautiful and it's fine.
Yes.
But your way is going to be different. Your way is going to be different, not in the purpose. You got purpose of peace and love and joy and connection, just like everybody who's doing the other thing. Your way is different in the means. Your way is different in the way you're going to achieve the goal.
Mm-hmm.
The way you're going to go about happiness is going to be different, but you got the goal of peace and joy and love and happiness and joining just like everybody else. But your way is going to be different. So a holy relationship, a real relationship, a really loving relationship has the purpose of saving you time.
Oh.
So a really loving relationship will save you time.
Oh.
An unloving relationship delays you. A real relationship saves you time. A holy relationship is a relationship that's based on the idea that we are here to recognize each other's beauty, each other's innocence, each other's power. I'm here to let you remember the truth about yourself that you might forget sometime with the things that you're telling yourself from what you learned in the past or what you think might happen to you in the future. You are afraid because you think about the past, you think about the future. I'm in your relationship to remind you that you are beautiful, that you're holy, that you're good, and that you're innocent, that you might make mistakes. Mistakes are for correction, but that beautiful self that you truly are that was created by God is still there no matter what you think about yourself, damn it.
Yeah. We'll take it.
Are you with me still?
Yes.
Now one instant spent together, just one instant really spent together with your brother, with another person, will restore the universe to both of you.
Wow.
1 minute of actually being with the person without your projections, without your past, without your scripts, without your guilts, without your fears, would restore universe of happiness and joy and peace and abundance to you forever.
Ooh. Yeah.
Forever. See, I want to hear the Course in Miracles. That's why I'm doing it this way. I want to hear what this is saying. Because it's difficult sometimes to hear what the Course in Miracles is saying when you're trying to study it by yourself.
Yep.
And then if we come here and still don't let ourselves hear it because we're analyzing it to death, then we walk away and we never heard the Course in Miracles. Because you know if you're not studying at home, and then you come here and all I do for an hour is answer questions that you're defending against what you're hearing about, you still want to hear what the Course in Miracles is saying. So before we even question it, let's hear it. Because it's impossible not to hear the truth when we join together.
That's right.
The stuff that seems like inconceivable that I'm saying right out of the book that your mind says, I don't understand what that book is saying. You understand it now. Because we're joined on the purpose of healing and loving with each other. It doesn't matter the words that I'm using. What matters is that we came together to join. That's what's going to produce the miracles of healing in all of our lives. Your understanding is not a powerful contribution to the truth.
What?
Your understanding does not make the truth what it is.
That's personally insulting.
The fact that you understand it does not have any effect on what's true or not. You don't have to understand that you're innocent. You don't have to understand that you're loved. You don't have to understand that you're powerful. You don't have to understand that your thoughts create your reality and you're not a victim of the world you see. You don't have to understand that. You just need to remember that.
Yeah. And use it.
That's the answer to it. So the Course in Miracles says, and this, listen to this, brothers and sisters. You are prepared. You are prepared. God.
That's good to know.
Did you hear that?
That's nice.
You
to hear.
Are prepared. You 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 are prepared. Now you need but to remember, you need do nothing. The only thing you need to remember is you need do nothing. The only thing you need to remember is you need do nothing. 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 You need do nothing!
All right. Okay.
You need do nothing. You need do nothing. You need do nothing. You need do nothing.
What do I need to do?
Nothing.
It would be far more profitable. It would be far more profitable now. Merely to concentrate on that you need do nothing than to consider what you should do. It would be a better payoff right now if you just considered you need do nothing than to sit up there and consider what you need to be doing. It would be better for you to focus on you need do nothing than to consider what you should be doing. That should be bringing up sufficient fear and confusion and disorientation in many people in the room. Right?
What do you mean?
Because we are doers.
Yes, we are.
We are makers. We are figure-it-outers.
Yes.
So when you tell us we don't need to keep doing what's always failed, we get upset. This guy's trying to undermine me. I come up with my latest plan to deceive myself, and he's saying I shouldn't be using it. I come up with the next script that somebody should be fulfilling for me to be happy. What is he talking about? I already have it figured out in my mind the next thing in my life that needs to change in order for me to be saved. I already know who needs to speak differently, act differently. I already know I need to be in another place, another time, with another person, in another job, in another situation. I already know that I'm using my mind to figure out what is it beside my own mind that needs to change in order for me to be happy.
Yes.
I'm trying to use my mind to figure out what other than my own mind needs to change in order for me to be happy. I'm using my mind to figure out what other than my mind needs to change in order to be. My mama needs to change. My daddy needs to change. My brother needs to change. My sister needs to change. My weight needs to change.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Everybody knows if I lost 10 pounds, happiness would be mine.
Yes. Yes.
You better tell you life and bliss is here.
Everybody knows that.
Everybody knows that. Everybody knows if you won the lottery, you'd be happy.
Yeah. Except for the people who won it.
Which kind of let us know immediately that in and of itself is not the key.
Yeah.
Because you read about people every day who have won the lottery, who are more miserable than if they never won the lottery. That's not saying that everybody that wins the lottery is going to be unhappy, but anybody who wins the lottery believing the lottery is what's going to make them happy, they're the ones who are going to be unhappy. Nobody's giving you love. Nobody can give you love. Nobody can give you love. Nobody can give you love. There's not a person in your life that can give you what you lack. They can join with you on the remembrance of the abundance that we all share. Because nothing's broke about you.
Yeah.
Except your bank account.
and your tooth.
You are prepared. You just need to remember you need do nothing. It would be far more profitable merely to concentrate on you need do nothing than to consider what you should do. So when peace comes at last, I love this. Check this out. I got to put a little bit of drum.
Oh, is that drum? What is that? The will to
that's
stick?
That's the dying crane.
I'll say.
There was a time in my life I didn't practice yoga, but I did practice hoga. Those are the prettiest in positions, too.
There's some stretching.
There's a little stretching. That was all mental.
Yeah.
Oh, thank God for people with a sense of humor. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. I tell you, the Course in Miracles says that the way we got in the situation at the end where we experienced fear and unhappiness is that we remember not to laugh.
Yeah.
We remember. We keep remembering not to laugh.
That was silly.
If it's time for us to laugh, but we keep remembering not to.
And it's
so the Course in Miracles is letting us know that when you get through and when peace comes to you at last, those who wrestle with temptation, when peace comes at last to those who wrestle with temptation, whoo, when peace comes at last to those who fight against giving in to sin, I'm trying to control it. I'm fighting. The Course in Miracles says, when the light comes at last into the mind given to contemplation, when the truth comes at last into the mind that's contemplating, or when the goal is finally achieved by anyone, when the goal of happiness and joy and peace is finally achieved with anyone, it always comes with just one happy realization. When your happiness comes and you really have true joy, it's going to come with just one happy realization. I need to do nothing. You're going to realize, my God, it never was about me doing anything, actually, at all.
No.
The Course says, here is the ultimate release, which everyone one day will find when? In his own way, in his own time. In your own way, in your own time, you're going to come to the realization that you need do nothing.
Yep.
As a matter of fact, time has been saved for you. You don't need this time. You don't need this time. It says time has been saved for you because you and me are together.
Mm-hmm.
What's saving us time is that you and your brother are together. You and your brother and sister are together. We are here to save each other time. And the Course says this is the special means that the Course in Miracles is using to save you time. What the Course in Miracles is using to save you time is that you have us, we have you, and we have each other. That's what will save us time.
Yeah.
Our relationships with each other will save us time. And the Course says, you are not making use of this Course in Miracles if you insist on using means which have served other people well.
Mm-hmm.
You are not making use of the Course in Miracles if you keep on using the ways that served other people but not use the way that's made for you.
Mm-hmm.
Now, this may not be the way made for you.
Right.
How do you know that this is not the way made for you? Because you don't want to use it. Stop really deep. If you have absolutely no interest in using the Course in Miracles, studying the Course in Miracles, practicing the Course in Miracles, then this is not your way. But for those of you who are sitting here and you know there's a part of you that resonates with these teachings, even if you're not studying it yet, even if you're not doing it yet, understand that this is the way made for you. The way made for you is what way? The way of knowing that we have each other. Your relationships will become the way that you recognize the truth and the happiness and the joy that you have. That's what's going to save you time. And it says you are not making use of the Course if you insist on using means which have served others well. What does that mean? You're neglecting what was made for you.
Mm-hmm.
Stop neglecting the path that was made for you. Stop neglecting the path that was made for you. So what do? Save time. For me. Save time for me. How do you save time for me? You only need to make one preparation if you want to save time. What is that? Practice. It says save time for me by only this one preparation. What's the one preparation? Remembering I need to do nothing. And then practice doing nothing else. Practice doing nothing but nothing. And I'm going to explain to you what that means, because it doesn't mean what you think it means.
No, yeah.
It doesn't mean don't get up in the morning and go to work because I said you need to do nothing. It doesn't
Thank
mean
you.
Don't pay your bills because I said you need to do nothing. That's not what it's saying. That's not what it's saying. Actually, what it's saying is that when you say I need to do nothing, you're making a statement of allegiance to God. You're making a statement of allegiance to your higher power. You're making a statement of allegiance to love and the universe. You're making a statement of allegiance to something greater than your own ego and your own fears. As a matter of fact, you have a truly undivided loyalty when you say, I need do nothing. Believe that you need do nothing for just one instant. Believe you need do nothing for just one instant. Believe you need do nothing for just one instant. And what did the book say? You will accomplish more than is given to a century of contemplation. A century of meditation. A century of struggle against temptation. You could just one instant believe that you need do nothing, because all things come from that which created you, and you would accomplish more than meditating 100 years, fighting against your temptations for 100 years, wouldn't accomplish more than going, I need do nothing.
Yeah.
Now I'm going to tell you what I need do nothing means. Can I do that?
Yes.
All right, here we go. Let's take one funk minute.
One funk minute.
I need do nothing. What? I need do nothing. Somebody sing it with me. I need do nothing. Say it slowly. I need do nothing. Take a breath, go. I need do nothing. You got to get your body in it now. I need do nothing. I need do nothing. I need do nothing. Woo! I might have been born in the segregated South as a black man, but one advantage was that I got a boogie chakra. I never looked like there was a pressure to be in the color that I am,
yeah.
But I got a boogie chakra. So I go, I need do nothing. Say what now? I need do nothing. Okay. Sometimes I get through teaching and people say, I enjoyed your show. You missed the point. I always want to tell them, you totally missed the point. If you think I'm putting on a show for you, then you missed the point. It's not the form. It's the content. It's the class.
That's right.
Because I let myself enjoy myself doing it doesn't mean I'm putting on a show for you because I'm being myself.
That's right.
I'm not here to perform. Black folk always perform for white folk. It's the safest thing you can do. The most non-threatening.
Yeah.
If Obama shows the slightest bit of anger, people freak out. It's another angry black man at that point.
Yeah.
I learned that in the past, now I must not project it into the future.
Yeah.
You see? I need to forget my body for just one instant, then the healing occurs.
Yes.
Earl is a black man. Oh, boom, now the healing occurs.
Yeah.
I'm more than what I thought I was.
Yes.
Just an instant.
Just an instant.
Then I look back at it and go, oh, I'm not looking at it quite the same way as I looked at it before. It's not determining my fate and what happens to me in the world, the color of my skin. Oh, because I'm not the color of my skin. I'm not a black man. I'm just playing the role. Earl Purdy, black man. Black Superman, thank you.
Yeah.
Okay. So, if you recognize you need to do nothing, so here we go. To do anything involves the body. 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 If you recognize you need to do nothing, if you recognize you need to do nothing, you've actually withdrawn the body's value from your mind. If I can do it without my body, then the body is not the most valuable thing. If I can do it with my mind, then my body is not the most valuable thing. If my happiness comes from my mind, if my pleasure comes from my mind, if my joining and my love and my truth and my freedom comes from my mind, then it releases the value of the body in my mind. And the Course says, that's the quick and open door through which you slip past centuries of effort. And escape from time. So how do you get past centuries of effort? Recognize that to do anything, so we think it involves the body. So this is the way in which sin, fear, and guilt lose all attraction right now, is for you to realize that you are more than your body and you more than anything that your body has ever done. Mm-hmm. And when you do that, he says, time is denied, the past and future gone, because who needs to do nothing has no need for time. I only need time if I'm trying to have my happiness in the future. I need the future, which is a part of time, in order for me to have my happiness. But if I don't need to have the future in order to be happy because I can choose to see myself truthfully right now, then I don't need time anymore.
Yeah.
Because the happiness that I desire is now.
That's
I don't need
time.
The time to be happy if I'm happy now.
Yeah.
Yep. I don't need time to be happy if I can change my mind about who I am and allow myself to be happy right now, not after that next car, after that next house, after that next degree, after that next sex, after that next relationship. If I let go of my belief that I need to prepare for my happiness in the future based on some things that I come up with that I think is going to make me happy that never satisfies me when I achieve them anyway based on what's happening in the past, then I can start to see how I could be happy in the things that are happening around me right now.
Amen.
And so then I don't need time. But then I don't need to do anything. He says, who need do nothing has no need for time. Mm-hmm. So what does to do nothing mean? Now, this is what it's about to say. It says to do nothing. Those of you following me, you know I'm just speaking what's on the page in a conversational way. He says to do nothing is to rest. The book is saying rest.
What?
Americans.
No. Possible.
Freaking America. I went overseas teaching. Yeah, went over to Spain teaching. Everybody chill out a certain time of the day. They chill out, Americans. Even on vacation, texting, talking, reading, writing. We don't know how to do nothing. It's
That's
pitiful.
True.
And then after all that doing, how you doing? Okay. You're doing your butt off. You're not any happier
right.
than you are. No. I got my next plan. I just came up with it. And I want you to do your part in it.
Yeah.
I made a parole for you, by the way.
Yeah.
And if you don't do it, you don't support me.
That's right.
And so we need to go get counseling. I'll sign a role to you and you aren't doing it.
Yeah.
You don't love me.
That's right.
Crap! Total crap. Total crap. You didn't even ask me if I wanted to play a role in the play that you made up for the happiness you're supposed to have. You saw me from across the room and said, he's the one. Oh, Lord. This time you see somebody, well, I just fell in love with you. Just go, I just fell in fear with you. Then A Course in Miracles says, to do nothing is to rest. It's to make a place within you where the activity of the body ceases to demand attention. In other words, just give yourself a moment where you're not focused on all the things you're making up that you think you need in order to be happy. Just have a minute that you're not always concentrating on your plan and what it is you think needs to happen for you to be happy. He says, and just for a minute, take your mind off the activities of your body. The body, and somebody else's body, by the way. I know I went too far. I know. So I got to take my mind off your body. Okay. It's got to cease to demand my advantage.
Yeah. Better close your eyes.
All right, I'll just go back to the 100 years of contemplation and meditation. Okay. And so into this place where you're not freaking out about what your body is doing, it says the Holy Spirit comes, your higher power comes, and then abides there. That means your higher power will remain when you forget. And when do you forget? You forget when your body's activities return to occupy your conscious mind. Mm-hmm. When you forget, every time you get back into your body activities again, you forget the truth when you get back into your body activities again. What does that mean? I've forgotten that I'm not alone. Yeah. I've forgotten that I have help. I've forgotten that there's a greater power than me to help. Why? Because I'm busy now with my body activities that I'm doing to try to make myself be happy. And the Course in Miracles says, yet there will always be this place of rest that you can return to. And you will be more aware of this quiet center of the storm. Okay, I call it my psychic territorial power. My psychic territorial power is that place that I have decided there's an imaginary line of my being that I don't let anybody come across.
Yeah.
There's a certain point that I'm going to stop being concerned and allow myself to be influenced by you or anything else happening outside of me. This quiet center in the middle of the storm. He says, then you'll become more aware of your quiet center than all the raging activity of the storm of your life. This quiet center in which you need do nothing will remain with you. When? It's going to give you rest in the midst of every busy doing that you're going on all day. You'll be out in the world doing your thing, but you have this central peace within you that cannot be touched because you know you more than your body and all the activities that seem to be going on in the world. Who you are is beyond all of that. He says, from this center, what center? The center that you're not focused on your body activities and all your ego needs and thoughts. He says, you will be directed how to use the body sinlessly. Mm-hmm. You're going to be directed how to use your body without guilt.
Yes.
You're going to be taught how to use your body without fear.
Yes.
You're going to be taught how to use your body without depression and upset
yes.
and insanity. He
yes.
says, it is from this center
yes.
from which your body's activities are absent that will keep you centered and unaware of the body in your awareness of it. You're gonna stay aware of the center of your peace that, and love that cannot be touched by anything.
Mm-hmm.
If just for a minute you go, I didn't do nothing, mm-hmm. what does that mean? I need to stop letting this activity affect me for a minute. I need to realize that I'm giving this all the meaning that it has for me. I need to realize that I'm not a victim of the world I see. I need to recognize that I don't understand what anything is for. I need to recognize that I don't perceive my own best interest. I need to recognize that I don't know what anything is for. I need to recognize that I rest in God. I need to recognize that I'm sustained by the love of God. I need to recognize that I have only one problem, and that problem has already been solved. I need to recognize that if I defend myself, I'm attacked. When you say the truth to yourself, you are creating that space within you that the activity of the body are not demanding your attention, because you're focusing on the truth, and the truth will set you free. Yeah. Thank you for hearing this much from me. Yeah. Woo. Encourage me. Thank you. Because all that make me do this, I give you more, baby.
Give us more, baby.
I'm saying you deserve love. So let's do the financial special appreciation. I'm going to do a little quick recap in just a moment. Those of you online, if you'd like to make a financial expression of appreciation, then just go to my website. www.earlpurdy.com. And those of you who are interested in having a one-on-one session with me, so you can let go of these blocks that you've been hanging on to since you were a kid, then I do one-on-one sessions called Clarity Sessions. And those of you where we take all of this information and we apply it to your situation. And for those of you who are open to it, I've also been an astrologer and numerologist for over 40 years. And the Holy Spirit uses every skill you've learned to bring people to the awareness of the truth. So whatever you've learned to do, it can be used by your higher power to bring you to an awareness. Don't let anybody believe you that just because you study something spiritual, it means you can't use the talents and skills that you've acquired in the world. It's a trick. It's a lie. That's your way of serving. That's your way of letting love come through you to help others. So those who are open to it, and thank you, I'm a full-time teacher of this, and God gives to me through the people who appreciate that which I do. And so thank you for seeing enough value in what I do to give me what you'd like to receive if you were sharing. Amen. I appreciate that so much. So, Tuesday night I do a class called The Way of Mastery. Awesome class.
Yes.
Awesome class. And CJ does a class at 6:30 on Sunday called A Course of Love, which I call the sequel to The Course in Miracles. It's absolutely an incredible material, especially of interest to those who've been studying The Course in Miracles and those who haven't. But it's incredible material. It's called A Course of Love.
Amen.
So The Course in Miracles, The Course of Love, The Way of Mastery, you study those three things, they'll blast you out of whatever block you have, right out of it. If you're sincere about changing, then the Holy Spirit, the universe, and the truth has provided you with a way to do it. And my good friend Annika Kadawa is over there, and she does a Course in Miracles class at Monday night at the Rocky Mountain Miracle Center here in Denver. What time is your class, Anna?
7:30 every Monday night, 7:30 to 9.
She's a fantastic Course in Miracles teacher.
Uh-huh. Amen.
Absolutely.
Yes.
That's right. And she's juicy and cute.
Amen.
So that's the truth.
I've got on my ACIM cheer outfit today.
That's right. That's right. I need to get you a cheer, do a little cheer for us. Okay, you know. Because it's really time for good times.
Yes,
it's really time for us to let ourselves. It's really time for us to let ourselves. It's time to let ourselves have joy.
It is.
Now, if I've upset anybody in here, it just means you didn't hear what I said. And you're innocent and I'm innocent. Because all I've said is you deserve to be happy. All I've said is you deserve to have love. Now listen to me. It said you need not do anything. You need to. Now what does that mean? It doesn't mean you don't. You sit on your butt and don't do anything physically. It means that just for a minute, you let go of what you're telling yourself long enough for your higher self to dwell in you. It just means just for a minute, get off your position so that your greater self can tell you exactly what to do, so that you can have this place within you that nothing in this world affects. You want to have this place within you that you'd never give your peace of, no matter what. So get this place within you and let yourself go. I need to nothing. I need to listen to the voice of God. I need to nothing. I need to listen to the voice of God. I need to nothing. I need to listen to the voice of God. Now remember that your relationships are here to save you time. But if you're in a relationship with someone that you resent, hate, and have grievances with, that relationship is not saving you time. Unless you are really willing to use the relationship to get in touch with your blocks and remember good times. That's what you're here for. These are the good times. That's what time it is. Leave the world behind. Do you hear me? These are the good times. You gotta let yourself have it. Let yourself have it. You need to do nothing. Just find a place within you where the activities of the body cease to demand your attention. Stop listening to your ego. What does that mean to stop listening to your ego? I'm gonna tell you, I'm gonna tell you, I'm gonna tell you. Listening to your ego is listening to that part that tells you that you are alone and separate from God. When you listen to your ego, you can always tell when you listen to your ego, because when you are listening to your ego, you feel afraid, you feel angry, you feel depressed, you feel sad, you feel lack. There's no joy in your mind, and something's kicking your behind. When you are focused on what is true, you turn around and you say, my life is through, and good times. Say what? These are the good times. Say what? Leave your cares behind. Say what? These are the good times. I tell you, one little announcement before we run out.